So the opening ceremonies for the Sochi Winter Olympic Games tomorrow night, 8 o'clock on KCRA 3. You can watch them. Maybe you're having a opening ceremony party, and a lot of people like to watch them together. Or maybe throughout the Olympics, you're going to want to cook some Russian food. So we are going Sochi style here with the Cordon Bleu chef instructor Adrian Day-Murchison. Adrian, thanks for being here with us this morning.
Thank you for having me.
So this is kind of Russian-esque, you were saying.
Yes.
You're calling it Russian-esque.
Yes.
So what are you going to show us how to make? Because this is actually, I love anything on a stick is good if you're having
a
party.
You can't go wrong with that. So we have chicken kebabs here. I'm going to be showcasing some of the techniques we show to our students at the school. And with the kebabs, I had this marinating for about 24 hours in some olive oil, salt and pepper, garlic, shallots, and coriander seeds. So some of the ingredients that we're using is where we're getting the Russian.
Did you tenderize that meat at all before?
That's what marinating does. It helps to obviously add the flavor, but it's going to help to kind of tenderize it, add moisture to your meat too, so that way you have moist chicken in the end.
Nothing worse than dry chicken on a stick.
Exactly.
Than just dry chicken.
So I've had this going, and I'm just skewering it up right now, and I'm going to go ahead and move over to my grill right here.
Oh, look, you can see those onions there.
Okay. You can smell it.
And that's a medium-sized onion that you use there?
It's a small onion.
Oh, that's a small onion.
This one's a small onion right here.
Good to know.
So, yeah, like I was saying, we showcase some of these techniques to the students, such as grilling, and one of the things we try to get across to them, especially in their last class, is does it matter the cuisine that you are doing? A braise is a braise, a grilling is a grilling, a sauté is a sauté. So as they learn along in the program all the different techniques, when they get to the last class, they shouldn't feel too scared about if it's Russian, Chinese, or African. It's just changing ingredients, but the cooking technique is the same, and that's something, especially with grilling, that a lot of them get really excited about. So that's something that we try to show to the students and get them more involved and comfortable when they're learning at the school as well.
Okay. So how long will you leave this on here?
We're going to go ahead and let this grill for about 2 to 3 minutes on each side, and I actually kind of go all the way around because sometimes, depending on the chicken piece, you want to try to get every side as you're grilling, so that way you don't get a little sticky sick. And
you don't want people leaving your Olympic party sick.
Exactly.
And the next day.
And so we have the finished product right here. We just want to obviously get that nice, what I call GBD, golden brown and delicious color on there. Okay.
You served it up with a little rye?
A little bit of rye bread. And I actually toasted it, and then right when it came out of the oven, a little bit of garlic clove on there. Give it some more flavor.
Is that something they would do in Russia or in Sochi? Or is that just Adrian?
That's an Adrian tip. That's what I like to do.
From Le Cordon Bleu.
I put garlic on everything.
All right.
And then what I have right here, if you want to create kind of a beautiful centerpiece for your own opening ceremony party tomorrow, we have what's called a salmon kubiak, which is going to be a salmon dish that's encased in puff pastry. So on the inside, we have salmon, rice pilaf, as well as sauteed mushrooms and onions.
Yum.
And hard-boiled eggs.
Can we cut it open? Can you tear it open?
I don't want to hurt my fish.
He's
napping right now.
You don't want to gut that fish. So pretty. Sorry.
So encased in puff pastry. So that's why we get that nice kind of golden crust to it.
It is beautiful.
Thank you so
much.
Okay,
I think Tamara's our taster, though. She's going to go ahead and taste it,
Tamara. Am I going to be okay? I'm not going to get sticky sick.
I promise. It is cooked, so you can go ahead and try it.
All right. I like the GBD, so you put a little EVO and then go for the GBD.
EVO and then GBD. It's all those little acronyms we like to utilize. So,
from the LCB.
Exactly.
Le Cordon Bleu.
It's really tasty. Thank you so much.
Very good. And what is...
We have dill here.
Dill, okay.
Dill.
Oh, because
nice
if it's not in a jar
flavor.
With the name on it, I know.
I only know it as dill weed in a container, exactly.
But no, if you guys are interested in coming by, we have an open house this Saturday on February 8th, starting at 10:30, and it's actually Valentine's Day. Chocolate treats. So you can tour the school and get some goodies while you're at it.
Love it. All right. We've learned so much, or at least I have. All right. Thank you so much. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Go Team USA.